Blue Devil fans. We are so excited that you've tuned in to the Blue Devil Network Morning Show. We have some very fun, interesting, exciting information you're not going to want to miss. I'm Charlie, and Carolyn will be bringing the second half of the announcements today. Today is April 1st, 2020. April Fool's Day is not a national holiday, but it is celebrated in the United States and many other countries. It is sometimes known as All Fool's Day. People like to play practical jokes all the way back to ancient Roman times, especially during the spring festivals. The celebration of All Fool's Day started in the Middle Ages. It was generally celebrated on March 25th throughout much of Europe up until the 1800s. Some funny pranks in history included 1998, Burger King announced a left-handed Whopper. They said they rotated some of the ingredients 180 degrees for left-handed people. A lot of people came to the restaurants and actually ordered one. And in 1996, Taco Bell announced that they had purchased the Liberty Bell and were renaming it the Taco Liberty Bell. People were very angry until they found out that it was only a joke. At this time, please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty for all. Please remain standing as we say our Marlow Elementary School pledge. I pledge allegiance to be a person of character. I will be worthy of trust. I will be respectful and responsible. I will show that I care. I will always act with fairness. I will always try my best. I will be a good citizen by following Forks Up behavior. I am an essential part of Model. I am Ari, Kenji, Naya, or Pilar. We are Model and we are family. You may be seated. Please pause for a moment for quiet reflection. Take it away, Addison.
Good morning, Blue Devils. Today for your Wednesday lunch, you will have peanut butter and jelly sandwich, baby carrots, cookies, fresh milk, and juice. For breakfast tomorrow morning, you will have a breakfast kit with milk. Thursday afternoon, students will be receiving meals to cover them through spring break. Have a great day. Back to you, Charlie.
Thank you, Addison. Before we send it over to Piper for our weather, we wanted to know what each of you have been doing while we're social distancing. Send us your videos or description of what you've been doing while we've been out of school. We miss seeing you every day and would love to feature you and some of our family on our show. Send your videos and descriptions of fun activities to Miss Turnquist. Her email is, and kids, gotta pay attention here. No capital letters, no spaces, anything. S Turnquist, that's TURNQUIST at floydboe.net. Alright. We can't wait to hear from you. Now I'll send it over to Piper for our weather today. Over to you, Piper!
Good morning, Blue Dog. Devil fans. Today for your weather, we are expecting mostly sunny skies. Our high temperature will be 61 degrees. Our low temperature tonight will be a very chilly 39 degrees. The wind will be from the northwest at 11 miles per hour. Our humidity will be 10% and the chance of rain is 0%. For Thursday, we are looking at warmer temperatures and partly cloudy skies. Thursday's high temperature will be 70 degrees with a 10% chance of rain. Have a good day. Now let's send it over to Caroline for the rest of our morning show.
Thank you, Piper. Before we talk about the website or app of the day, let's listen to Miss Bryant and Mila read Fancy Nancy Bonjour Butterfly. Stop it.
Hello, boys and girls. Today, you're going to have Miss Bryant with her assistant, Mila Pup, reading Fancy Nancy Bonjour Butterfly, since it is now springtime. And this is with permission from HarperCollins, and the author is Jane O'Connor. And this video will be deleted at the end of the school year. So, as you can see, Mila and I dressed up for this special occasion. So, without further ado, here we have Fancy Nancy Bonjour Butterfly. Written by Jane O'Connor and illustrated by Robin Glasser. Don't you think butterflies are exquisite? Exquisite is an even fancier word than beautiful. Whenever my friend Bree and I see one, we say bonjour. That's French for hello. Do butterflies understand French? My dad asks. Maybe, I tell him. Bree's birthday party is soon. Everything will look like butterflies, even the cake. I show her how to turn the bees into butterflies on the invitations. You're so lucky your name begins with a B, I tell her. Bree's butterfly birthday, Saturday at noon. Come as your favorite butterfly, RSVP. RSVP is short for Respondez, s'il vous plaît. That's French for please reply. I'm going as an azure butterfly. My wings are bright blue and what's that fancy word for shiny? Oh yes, iridescent. Bree's party is this Saturday. I can't wait. Oh no, cries Mom. I totally forgot. Then she says I can't go. My grandparents' anniversary party is the same day. Mom says, Bree's birthday is special, but being married for 50 years, that's exceptional. That's extraordinary. If my mother thinks using fancy words will make me feel better, she's wrong. When I tell Bree I can't come, she is heartbroken. For the next 2 days, I scowl and sulk and storm around the house. Mad is way too plain for how I feel. I am furious. On the train, the only person I talk to is Maribel. We mostly speak in French. Maribel's Nancy's doll. I perk up a little at the station. My grandparents are so thrilled to see me. Grandpa says, it wouldn't be a party without our glamorous granddaughter. I must say, the City Squire Motel is quite elegant. That's a fancy word for fancy. I curtsy to everyone. There is a candy machine in the hall and an automatic ice dispenser. And in the bathroom are those little bottles of bath gel and shampoo and cream. Ooh la la, it's like being at a beauty spa. At the party, I have so much fun. I forget to be furious. Grandpa teaches me the cha-cha, which is a type of dance. Waiters bring out tiny hot dogs on silver platters. Mmm, delicious, darling, I tell my sister. You must try one. Later, I whisper, I'm sorry, Mom, for the way I behaved. I am ecstatic to be here. It really is an extraordinary night. The next morning, my mother wakes me up. Grandma says the zoo here has a butterfly garden. Do you want to go? Oi, oi, oi! That's French for yes, yes, yes. My grandparents meet us at the zoo. Those are monarch butterflies on your tie, I tell Grandpa. My, you know a lot about butterflies, he says. Yes, I admit. I am practically an expert. The butterfly garden is gorgeous. Gorgeous is also fancier than beautiful. I can't wait to tell Bree all about it. Suddenly, a little blue butterfly flits toward me, an azure butterfly. All butterflies are special, but this one is extraordinary. Bonjour, I say. You know what? I am nearly positive butterflies understand French. So that was Fancy Nancy, Bonjour Butterfly, written by Jane O'Connor and illustrated by Robin Glasser, with permission to read and share from HarperCollins. And this will be deleted at the end of the school year. So I hope you enjoyed our story time today with Mila.
Thank you, Miss Bryant and Mila. Thank you, Miss Bryant and Mila. Don't forget to take an AR test on Fancy Nancy Bonjour Butterfly. If you're like me and running out of things to do at home, our friends at Google have you covered. They have launched their new 3D animal feature. The idea is pretty simple. First, you search an animal through Google. If you search an animal through Google, you will be able to project a 3D version into your home, yard, or pond. After you search the animal, scroll down to click View in 3D. You then have to move your phone around the room in order for the technology to work. The life-size animals can appear in your home through augmented reality and the camera on your phone. You can scale down the animal to make them smaller or scale him up to make them larger. You can even take photos or videos with the animal, providing hours of entertainment for the kids. You can currently see an alligator, anglerfish, brown bear, cat, cheetah, dog, duck, eagle, emperor penguin, goat, hedgehog, horse, lion, macaw, octopus, pug, giant panda, Rottweiler, shark, Shetland pony, snake, tiger, turtle, or wolf. Check out the Google R 3D animals today. You won't be sorry. April is Autism Awareness Month. Raising awareness about autism helps others understand individuals with autism. Autism is a complex developmental disability that affects social skills and communication. It is different for every person. The symbol for autism is the puzzle piece to show its mysterious and complex traits. accept others and their differences. We all have unique traits that make us different. Understand that individuals with autism may want to play alone or have different interests. Include students with autism to join in games and activities. Teach them to play, be kind and patient. Each individual with autism is unique, like the rest of us. Learn about them, be their friend, and encourage others to be kind. You will be blessed. Tomorrow, April 2nd, please wear the color blue and post your pictures on your social media with hashtag LightItUpBlueDevils and hashtag WeAreModel.
So besides being absolutely bored to death, I have managed to make this drawing that I'm kind of proud of. Now it's not that best because, you know, I'm just beginning, but yeah. It's supposed to be like a picture of Abraham Lincoln, but I only use his name. So, like, yeah. I don't know. I tried.
Don't forget to send your videos to Miss Turnquist so that we can feature you on our morning show. Also, we want to see how you are spreading joy around our community. Remember to send those pictures and videos to Miss Elliott. Until Friday, Blue Devils, forks up! Bye!